My approach to learning is to first get a solid understanding of the simplest cases. So today we will work through a two-node neural network, both by hand and with some basic Python. I'll try to keep the math as simple as possible. Hopefully this video will give you a solid start to learning neural networks. This is the basic structure of our two-node neural network. We have one node in our input layer with X as the input, and one node in our output layer. Since the output of a neural network is a prediction, we'll use Y hat to represent the prediction. And in the middle, we have W as the weight. Usually, we have a defined problem, then we construct a neural network to solve the problem. However, since we only have two nodes, what can we possibly solve with a two-node network? Let's see. The equation for this structure is y hat equal to w times x. Does this look familiar? It's the standard formula for a line. Usually there is an intercept here, but we'll exclude that for now. So what can a line do? Let's say we have some data points on a graph. What we can do is approximately fit a line through these points. Once we have this line, we'll be able to use this line to make estimates for if x is here, what would y be? Or somewhere around here. This is called linear regression. What a fancy name, right? But just remember, linear is a line, and regression, to regress is to go back, so just remember that we're going back to the old points to try to figure out what the new points would be. For our example, instead of using these 30 points, we'll make things simple and assume that we have these nice and neat points. So let me fill this table in. You can probably tell that the formula to the line that fits these points is just y equal to x, where w is just 1. Of course, you don't need a neural network to solve this, but for the purpose of our super simple example, just pretend that you don't know what the formula is, and just pretend that these points are not so nice and neat. Okay, let's start our neural network calculations to find a line that fits these points. Let's hop over to Visual Studio Code. I'm importing NumPy to help with the calculation and PyPlot to make some graphs. The points that I have over on my whiteboard is now defined here. We'll also define the forward pass function here. This is the same function that I had over on the whiteboard. It's called a forward pass because we are following the directions of the arrows going forward. We start by just guessing a random weight, let's say 0.5, then calculate the predicted y values, and then print it out and graph it. Let's see. The blue dots are the actual values that we know of, and then the green line represents the prediction at weight equal to 0.5. We can see that by adjusting the weight, we'll eventually find a good fitting line. The question is which direction to adjust W and by how much. We need some way to measure just how bad our guess of W was. This measure is called loss. Here's a way to remember it. Just imagine you're on a hike in the forest and you got lost. You need a way to calculate just how lost you are. Let me bring these predicted values over to my whiteboard. To calculate loss, what if we take y actual, this column, and subtract it by y hat? And then we'll take the average of these errors to see how bad it is. This cancels this, this cancels this. The problem is that if we add up all these values, the negative and positive numbers could cancel each other out, and we get 0, which gives the false impression that there is no error in our guess. Well, one way to get rid of the negative numbers is by squaring y minus y hat. So this becomes 1. Now before I take the average of these numbers, you can see that 0 multiplied by any weight is always going to give us 0. So it's really not very useful at all. So we should not consider 0 in our calculation. Okay, let's take the average of this. These four numbers added together divided by 4 is 0.625. This formula is actually known as mean squared error. Error refers to y minus y hat square to get rid of the negative numbers, and then mean to take the average. Now back at Python, here's the function that we just talked about, and then we'll define it in Python. Let's see how changing the weights affects loss. Since our first guess of 0.5 didn't look so bad, we'll just add a couple more guesses to a list, and then we'll calculate the prediction for each one of the W's and append the loss to the L list. We'll print it out and let's see what happens. So the second set of printout is the loss. If I connect the dots, it looks like a parabola. Finding the weight that makes loss 0 at the vertex here is what we want to do. If I draw a tangent line through these points, it gives us an indication of which direction to go. The lines on the left side have negative slopes, so increasing W decreases loss. The tangent lines on the right side have positive slopes. Decreasing W decreases loss. We need to convert the tangent lines into numbers. So what we need to do is find the slope. To find the slope, we need to take the derivative of this parabola. Now back at our diagram, we passed y hat into the mean square error function, which produces the loss. We can see that the loss is not directly dependent on W. In order to determine the derivative, which is how change in W affects change in loss, we need to first find the derivative of this portion, which is how the change in y hat affects the change in loss. Then we need to find the derivative of this portion, which is how the change in W affects the change in y hat. So basic multiplication, change in y goes away, and we have the change in loss and change in weight. Let's start calculating this side and then this side, and then combine them together. If your calculus is a little rusty, it's okay. I'm gonna make it super simple. Let's start with the easier equation first, which is this one. So delta y hat over delta w. Since delta w is the dependency, which means w is the variable of this equation, and x can be treated as a constant. We don't need to do anything to the constant, so bring it down. Now for the variable, we can do the derivative this way. We take the exponent of w, which is 1, bring it down here, and then subtract 1 from the exponent. So this is x again. 1 times w is w. The exponent 1 minus 1 is 0. W to the power of 0 is 1, so it goes away. And this is the derivative of y hat with respect to w. By the way, this is called the power rule. Okay, we're good with this side. Let's start on this side. Okay, we'll start with the mean square error function. What we want to find is the change in loss with respect to y hat. Again, since y hat is the dependency, y hat would be the variable of this equation. Everything else are constants. So we can make things simple by first just ignoring this part, and then we'll bring it back later. And then I'm going to multiply out this y minus y hat square. I'll add the i's back later. Now let's multiply it out. Y times y is 2y. Y times y hat is minus y, y hat, minus y hat times y, and then minus y hat, minus y hat. This becomes y hat square. The middle two is the same, so let's combine them. Okay, now we can see that 2y is a constant. We can just drop it. And then here we can use the same power rule, keep 2y, y hat to the power of 1. So similar to what happened to w, y hat just disappears. And then over here, we bring the exponent down. So 2 times y hat to the power of 2 minus 1, 2 y hat. Okay, so this is the derivative. We can bring all this stuff back. Here we go. Now we can combine them together. Bring this up here. Bring that over here. And this is it. Not that bad, right? Hey, before I continue, if you find this video helpful, please help me out with a subscribe and like. Back at Visual Studio Code, this is the equation that we had over at the whiteboard. And it is converted to a Python function. We have the 2x over here, the sum of the errors over here, and then taking the average, it's over here. Let's graph the same parabola from before, but add in the gradients. Notice that the farther away w is from the bottom, or the vertex, the bigger the slope is. We want to take advantage of this phenomenon. We do want to make bigger adjustments when w is farther away so that we could get to the vertex faster. But as we get closer to the vertex, we want to make smaller adjustments so we don't overshoot the target. Finally, we are ready to train our network. We will talk about the learning rate in just a second. One epoch is one pass of sending the input data forward through the network, and one pass of going back and adjusting w. We'll set epochs to 20 iterations. How do we know that 20 is enough or not? We don't. We have to just run it and see. We'll keep our original guess of w equal to 0.5. Inside the training loop, we use w and the input data to calculate y predicted, and then figure out how bad our guess of w was. Next, we do the partial derivative calculation. And finally, we make the updates to the weight. And this is called gradient descent. Gradient means slope, and descent means to go downwards. Let's talk about the subtraction here. Remember that this side is a negative slope. So when we use w to subtract a negative slope, it becomes a plus. So w plus the change actually makes it go this way toward the vertex. This side is a positive slope, so w minus the positive slope makes w go this way. And that's why we're doing a subtraction on this equation. Now let's talk about the learning rate. Notice how large the slopes are. If we use this to adjust w, it's just gonna go fly off the chart. We need to use a factor as a way to reduce the slope to a scale closer to w. Let's say we use 0.1. This will scale it down to -3, which is still a bit too big for our weight. So it looks like if we scale by 0.01, this should work. If we scale this number too small, it will unnecessarily increase the training time. This factor is called a learning rate because it affects the weight of training. So here we're setting the learning rate to 0.01, and we're using it down here to scale down the gradient. Let's run the training. We can see the weight being adjusted over time, and then we can see the loss getting smaller and smaller. However, at 20 epochs, we're still not close to zero yet. So let's try 50 epochs. I'm going to run it again. We'll look at the lost. So it's not printing everything, but it seems like between 25 to 47 epochs, the loss has already reached zero. That means it has found that our weight is 1, which is correct since our function was y equal to x. Let me change the input data set to maybe y equal to -2x and make sure our training actually still works. So this would be 4, 2, -2, -4. Let's graph it. Okay, this is y equal to negative 2x. Back to our training code. Let's change the weight to 10, see what happens. Let's do the training. I think we need a little bit more training. Let's change it to 60. Okay, here we go. It finds that w is equal to negative 2. So y equal to negative 2x. Looks like our training does work. Remember at the beginning, we said that we'll save the intercept for later. Let's add it back. On the output node, there's actually a bias, which is added to the equation. Now let's change our input data set to include an intercept and see how we can estimate the bias. This is y equal to negative 2x. I'm going to add an intercept of 2. That brings it to 6, brings it to 4, brings it to 0, negative 2. Graph it. Here's y equal to negative 2x with a intercept of 2. Similar to w, we need to find change of loss with respect to change of the bias. Change of l with respect to y hat times change in y hat with respect to change in bias. We already have this. We need to find this. To find this, we start with this equation. Since the bias is on the bottom, b is the variable, wx is the constant. We'll just drop the constant. And then to derive b, we take the exponent of 1 minus 1 and then bring the exponent down. This gives us b to the power of 0, which is 1, dl over db. This side is a 1. So change in loss with respect to change in bias is simply the change of loss with respect to the change of y hat. And I have the equation here, convert it to Python. Now let's go down to the training. What do we need to adjust to the training? We need to adjust our forward function. The forward function needs to add the bias. We need to add the gradient for the bias. We need to make a guess of what b is, make it 10 also. And now we do the same equation as the w. Let's print b. Make sure to pass in b here. Also pass in b here. Now we can do the training. Our loss is really big. Let's make it 200. Try again. Our loss is getting better. Let me just go straight to 500. Train again. Here we go. Our loss is good enough for now. So we do find w equal to negative 2, b equal to 2. So we pass in 10. We get negative 18, which is good. Ooh, that was a lot of work, huh? Hey, help me out with a subscribe, like, comment, share, whatever. If you find this video helpful, I'll catch you in the next one.